For Final Cut Pro users, I'm pleased to advise that it's okay now to upgrade to macOS 15.1, currently just become available. I'll show you Final Cut Pro running with no issues from titles or generator plugins, the ones that I use anyway, and I can assure you that I've got hundreds of plugins, not one red warning screen in sight. And now let's look at some of the effects plugins that may stress the upgrade. First, the lock and load stabilizer from C2. Then the keeper plugin from Sheffield Softworks. The screen background will be removed. I'll adjust the thin control to remove some of that green in my hair. Now the skin smoother. Now let's look at the multi-purpose shot anvil plugin, also from C2. I'll draw a green overlay over the Jaguar logo. Now I'll use the clone tool. And I wanted to show you the headline feature for the new macOS 15.1. It's iPhone mirroring, and I found this a really useful app. It's in the Applications folder, so I'd suggest you drag it into your dock. There are some settings to change, and you'll find your iPhone locked up during the process, but everything's available on your Mac screen, and you directly use your keyboard and mouse. Consider being able to type directly from your Mac keyboard into apps on the phone that are not installed on your computer. The Watch app, for instance. Maybe banking authenticator apps that you only have on your iPhone. And one case in point for me is that I've got Bose smart speakers. Bose don't provide a Mac app, but with iPhone Mirror, I can access my smart speakers without picking up my iPhone. The iPhone only needs to be close. It can be wireless or connected by a cable to the computer and mirrors on your Mac screen. And you can move it to different parts of the screen, even resize the view. But be aware that the iPhone isn't usable while it's being mirrored. So what do you need to be able to do all this magic? iOS 18, an M1 or higher silicon Mac with both on the same Wi-Fi network. So let me show you how to set up for iPhone mirroring. The setup's a one-off process. I'll also show you the easy connection after the setup's been completed. With iOS 18 installed on your Mac, go to the application folder, locate the iPhone mirroring app, and drag it into your dock. The first time you launch the app, there'll be an explanation screen. Just click continue. And it'll ask you to unlock your phone. So enter your phone's password on the phone. Then choose to allow or not for notifications. Then get started. Enter the computer's password now, and then choose from the login options. You'll now see the home screen of your iPhone. That's it, the setup's complete. And any subsequent connections simply require a password to connect. So here's a second connection. Press the iPhone mirror app in the dock, enter the password, and that's it, it's connected. And you're now on your home screen or whatever screen your iPhone was displaying before you started mirroring. And you can navigate using the mouse or trackpad by clicking on the bar at the bottom of the iPhone screen to go to the home page, or hover up to go to the app switcher icon or the home screen by selecting the grid image. And there are simple keyboard shortcuts, or use the view menu. Command 1 to show the home screen, Command 2 to show the app switcher, Command 3 to show the iPhone search, Command plus to show a larger screen, and Command minus to decrease the size. I've selected the app switcher. Scroll left or right on the magic mouse or trackpad to move the iPhone's apps, as if you were swiping with your finger when using the iPhone screen. Scroll up on the mouse to do a swipe up. Click on the apps window to launch that app. Mail in this case. I've selected Command 2 to go back to the app switcher. Now Command 3 to search. And I've clicked on the YouTube Studio app. Command 1 to go back to the home screen. And now for the window menu, I'll move the iPhone's window around the Mac screen. And another thing to note is that you don't see the normal iPhone keyboard on the mirrored screen, as the Mac keyboard is automatically recognized. So you can just type whenever there's a type cursor on the mirrored screen. I've selected the Notes app and open a list to add some text by typing from the keyboard. Reduce the size by selecting Command minus, Command plus, and I've started a new note. By returning to the home screen, I can scroll left and right on the magic mouse or the trackpad to represent swipes on the iPhone screen. Select the phone button on the mirror screen to call or send a message. And perhaps the most unique feature is that files can be copied from the iPhone to the Mac or vice versa with drag and drop by copying to the files folder on the iPhone or directly into an app, say a photo dragged into Facebook. It's certainly going to be a feature that I'll use. Thanks for watching.